After uploading the video I made last night on Dave Mustaine in Japan paying tribute to Chris Cornell, who supposedly committed suicide. Nothing more than a hoax, nothing but a fabrication. And all these Dave Mustaine fans, these knuckleheads, that have no idea what they're talking about. They don't know the difference between their butt and a hole in the ground. They're saying, he's just doing this sign because he has a pick in his hand. You people have no understanding. These deceivers, you know, these so-called Christians in the music industry. There are no Christians that make it on top of this world. You only have these fakes, just like Stryper, the lead singer, Michael Sweet as well, okay? People just want to rationalize their false belief system that they've been taught, they've been spoon-fed by these deceivers. Again, you're not going to make it on top of this world unless you sell out, and they're just playing the role of Christians. These are fake Christians. Now, getting back to this video clip from Japan with Dave Mustaine, supposedly all sad over the passing of Chris Cornell. Like I stated many times, nothing but a hoax, nothing but a fabrication. And like I stated many times, you cannot fake real. There's nothing real about this. There's no sadness with Dave Mustaine. He's just acting sad. Take a look.
Chris Cornell died today.
Yeah.
Very sad. Very sad. Like Chris, I could never sing like Chris, but we're going to sing a song right now. And if you know the words, sing with me.
See how his hands are open? Now, there's a potential he has a pick between his index finger and his middle finger while he's talking, okay? And he might just switch it over to have the pick between his thumb and the index finger. But again, this is on purpose what he does here.
If you don't know the words, then just...
It does look like he's adjusting the pick in his hand. But again, this is for the symbolic 666 hand sign, which he's about to display.
Make noise.
Right there. Okay, this is how they do it. Again, same thing with Stryper. I played this video last night with this interview with Alex Jones. Anybody that's associated with Alex Jones that basically goes on his channel and does interviews, they're all part of the rig system, the rig reality. They're all working together to deceive the masses. Now let's take a listen again at with this total contradiction from Dave Mustaine.
Changes in your life.
Yeah, it was pretty simple. I've always believed in God. That's why, you know, the first line of peace says, but who's buying says, what do you mean? I don't believe in God. I talk to him every day, you know.
He says he's believed in God his whole entire life. But then he says this, okay? Makes absolutely no sense. Total contradiction.
Got into black magic and went down the route of the occult. And although I didn't pursue being a Satanist, you know, I was very much agnostic and probably more atheist than I was anything.
Again, for a man that basically stated he believed in God his whole entire life, then he states he's an atheist. It's like a meat-eating vegetarian. Makes absolutely no sense. And again, getting back to Stryper, I want to play this video as well so people can connect the dots. How these so-called Christians in the music industry are nothing more than sellouts, nothing more than frauds. With this previous video I made a few years ago with these deceivers and all the connections I'm going to be showing in this video with, again, Stryper. Again, nothing more than deceivers, just like Dave Mustaine, this fake, phony Christian, 100% exposed.
I just saw this on CNN's website, this ridiculous comparison with Ted Cruz to one of the band members of Stryper. They look nothing alike. This is just free publicity for Stryper, who are nothing more than sellouts, just like them all. You have the mainstream secular music and the supposed Christian music. It's like if the right hand doesn't get you, the left hand will. And that's how they do it. First of all, let's take a listen to this clip here on CNN that I found pretty interesting.
This resembles is of Michael back when he was 22. The two do share the same religion, Stryper.
Yeah, the same religion of Satanism. All Freemasons.
There's a Christian heavy metal band. This is not the first time.
Love duality, split screen with these women, just like the movie Twins. This reminds me of.
Cruz has been accused of being a twin. Conan's just.
Now watch this here, what the lead singer of Stryper does.
Michael suggests one of the band's classics could serve as the Cruz campaign song. Rival Donald Trump in mind.
As he says, to hell with the devil, he throws up the 666 hand sign. So I guess to hell with the devil is literal. For those that don't know This is all about the cult of 666, just like all the puppets do in the game. So what's the difference with Stryper and all these mainstream artists, David Lee Roth, with the 666 hand sign, just like the Pope did, Madonna, Aerosmith, this woman here on SNL, just a little clever way of doing the same thing. Peter Gabriel doing it with the poster. Just a little tricky way of doing the same exact thing. Now just a little demonstration with the Pope in front of Congress doing the same exact thing. He puts a 666 hand sign up when he mentions God, but of course, it states in the Bible in Corinthians 4:4, Satan is the god of this world. So the devil and their God is one and the same. Take a look.
On the other, the fear of Moses leads us directly to God.
There you go. Same exact thing. God, the devil, again, their God and the devil are one and the same. And just taking a look at one of their music videos for the song called Free, just more occult symbolism right in plain sight. Take a look. Does right there. Every little thing they do, there's a reason. One arm up, his right, and his left arm down. This is Baphomet, you see here. And I'll explain this, as I've done before, what this all means, the right hand up, left hand down. This is all from the Bible. It states in Matthew, when Jesus returns, where all nations shall be gathered, they'll be separated from one another, as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. So there you go. You understand what's taking place. The right hand is for the sheep going to heaven, and the left hand for the goats going towards hell. So that's basically what this represents. The sheep go above and the goats below. Continue the video here a little bit more. So play from the start again. Just a short clip. Continue on with more occult hidden in plain sight. Another hand position, again, they speak with, not with words, but with hand signs and symbols, just like the Greek god, Hippocrates. You see him doing the sign of silence, this is what it's all about. Other ones, Barbara Bush, Obama, Darwin, John Kerry, Clinton, Ozzy Osbourne, Obama's former press secretary, all doing the sign of silence, all about the occult. Now just taking a look at Stryper here on Wikipedia. First thing I noticed, they're supposedly from Orange County. Some of the band members here, Michael Sweet, Robert Sweet, Tim Gaines, and I find this very interesting with Oz Fox. We'll look into that in a second. First off, let's take a look at this image here they have on Wikipedia. What do you see? Two pyramids within the pyramids, and three crosses above, and you have the rainbow colors, basically. Getting back to the band members' names, seems like Michael Sweet and Robert Sweet, that's their real name, Tim Gaines. One name caught my attention was Oz Fox. Let's take a closer look at who he is and what he's all about. Okay, it states here, get a little better shot here. He was born Richard Alfonso Martinez. How did he come up with the name Oz Fox? I'm reading through this, and basically it says, his high school friends called him Oz in honor of Ozzy Osbourne. But there's no mention why they call him Fox. And I'll explain that. What it all comes down to is Fox, as I mentioned many times, is 666 in Pythagorean numerology, just like Fox Film, Fox Theater, 20th Century Fox, Fox News. It goes on and on. And also with Oz, the cult of Oz, is 77 as well. One thing I noticed also, they're from Orange County. I'm not sure if that's just a coincidence or not, but nonetheless, as I mentioned, Orange is 33 in numerology. Of course, the highest degree in the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry. You have this one CD cover with Orange. Now, if you think this is all just a coincidence, let's take a look at this one video I found online. I find it pretty interesting. All relates to the occult of Orange when it comes to 33. Let's play this video. You'll see what I'm talking about. There you go. They have an amp, orange, and of course, orange, new black, all about the occult of orange, like I said.
In front of the gear that we have talked about for a long time, not just this record, but we've talked about showing you guys kind of our little secrets on getting the stripe.
Yes, your little secrets, the secrets of orange. It's all, again, about the occult. Just taking a look at their record albums, in this case their CD cover, you can see the use of the pyramid. Same thing here with the upside down pentagram. Always with the symbolism, the newest release with Second Coming. Of course, a mockery of Christ. Basically, of duality here with the two. It's supposed to be a D and a C. When you flip that D around, you get two C's for 33. This is how they love to mock Christ, hidden in plain sight. Also, the 777. This is the occult of Crowley. They'll present it as something good. That's what deceivers do. They shape 777, just like a pyramid. Like I said, it's the occult of Crowley. Aleister Crowley, a well-known Satanist. So, again, understand, when it comes to the music industry, they're all on the same team. These people pose as Christians, but they're not. They're far from. Like I said, if the right hand doesn't get you, the left hand will. This is how they do it. Nothing but deception when it comes to Hollywood and the music industry.